So Jurassic Park came out in the summer of 1993. And by the summer of 1996, Sid Sheinberg, Lou Wasserman, the Universal team, had determined, you know, to build a Jurassic Park ride. I had never seen such an ambitious project before coming out of the theme parks. But there's something that's kind of really, for me, almost like legacy, is when that movie has been given a permanence. And when they made the Jurassic Park ride, Jurassic Park suddenly had a home. And then when Jurassic World, you know, came out and was such a success, we all thought that we needed to expand the footprint and create a worldview of that particular movie.
I love Jurassic Park, I love that movie, but the movie is about a theme park that never opens. And finally, when we were able to make a film about a fully operational theme park, we opened up the opportunity to be able to bring people to a theme park. And so that's what we've done. You can watch Jurassic World, you can see other people go through that wonder and that awe and then that trauma and that fear, or you can come here and you can actually go through all those things yourself.
One of the things we wanted to do was make the ride authentic. And I think one way to do that is to have the cast from the movie participate in the experience that you're having on the ride.
Hello, I'm Claire Deering. I'm so thrilled that you're joining us here today.
What we've done is kind of establish the conceit that you're kind of watching Jurassic TV, if you will. You're at Jurassic World, you're seeing a lot of different episodes. We go to many different locations. We learned a little bit about the training of Blue. We learned some new information from Dr. Wu. And so we're kind of in this nice, fully immersive setting.
Well, I'm here today to play the character of Dr. Wu for the Jurassic World ride at Universal Studios. When you're gonna get on the ride, you kind of know at some point that some Jurassic stuff is gonna go down. And so watching him be super positive in the face of what you know is gonna happen is always kind of fun. That's part of the movie.
I do an all paleo diet. I try to have around 40 pounds of raw beef flank every morning. My colon's a nightmare. And look at these guns!
Hi, Chris. Well, Universal, this is what we want. We want the fans to feel like they are still in the world, and they are discovering new things and new stories where they get to be part of.
As we get on the ride, we're really going to go through that experience where dinosaurs ruled the world in the context of the Jurassic World series. So, of course, it's only natural that the first experience we see is the giant Mosasaurus.
I think the interesting thing for the guests is, you know, I think they expect to see some really amazing animatronic dinosaurs, but I don't think they expect to see an actual aquarium with a Mosasaurus in it. And we have, you know, we have this amazing structure. It's 100 feet long. It's filled with water. You're going to see water rising above you on either side, and you're going to actually see the Mosasaurus.
The Mosasaurus was, to me, one of the most important things we could do because it was something that was so unique. Something that's never been done before to create that kind of illusion of a grand aquarium.
So one of the things that the guests will learn in the attraction is they'll hear a little bit about the history, the Jurassic Park history, you know, the history of the science that came before, and then Dr. Wu's gonna explain how he's taken that science and built on it step by step and learned how to crossbreed dinosaurs and hybridize dinosaurs and to create entirely new creatures that the Earth's never seen before.
The Indominus is a very dynamic dinosaur for us. The level of detail is spectacular. I have to say that I've been blown away by what I've seen.
You're literally face to face with this dinosaur.
I love the idea as a fan of this meta experience, right? Like, you know, letting go for a minute and going, okay, I'm standing in the gate and it feels like I'm in Jurassic World.
I think people are always gonna love dinosaurs. Dinosaurs are real, they were here.
There's something that happens when you turn like two and a half where suddenly you point at a dinosaur and you say, I want to know what that is, I wanna know everything about it. And it's amazing how global that is, how completely universal that is. Children are fascinated by these creatures, and so to be able to provide that moment where their eyes pop open and they see something that looks genuinely real in front of them, that they feel they could reach out and touch. I remember that feeling, and it's pretty awesome to be able to give that to kids now.
When I was a kid, I was obsessed with dinosaurs, but the only place I could go to see a dinosaur was the Natural History Museum, and there were bones, and the bones were, of course, gargantuan, and I was a little kid, and it was intimidating and scary and at the same time very compelling. But today, the fact that you can go somewhere and you could both be entertained and you could also be informed that dinosaurs can be in the movies and in theme parks brought back to life. And that's thrilling.